Hi team, welcome back to the day five for our automation testing training with Selenium, Java automation frameworks, and also part of our JPACT 10th batch. So there were a few questions being answered that I want to address, team. There's an iTeLearn member can access videos plus live, okay? Then there's a JPACT member, and JPACT stands for Job Placement and Certified Training. For some of you team who are not, so sorry for others who, for whom it's boring, and Certified Training, okay? And here you have two additional things that's as simple, live projects, certifications, actually three, and placement assistance. Okay, so if someone, depending on where you are, you can choose it, but currently for any iTeLearn member, this is the training that you could participate and go on with. I missed yesterday's session, team, sorry about that, really apologize. I wanted to move it to 7 p.m. Pacific, but it was too late for people in the East Coast, so I had to little adjust it. Now, having said that, team, a couple of poll questions that I would love to get some answers from you. I don't know if how many of you have joined the session for the first time or not, but while you do that, can you look at this three poll questions, please? The poll is in front of you. Use your screen to just put your votes in. I'm going to pause the recording meanwhile. I actually didn't record at that time. Sorry about that, team. So the earlier poll results, but basically 80% of you were in JPACT members and about 20% of you were between the iTeLearn video members and non-members. I've got polls for the next question too. Your first QTP batch. Thank you, Fiza. And I know Fiza, you're right here in Los Angeles. We will catch up sometime. Thank you. All right, great. Who else do I have? Closing this poll, 93% votes in. Anyone missed? Close and share. So I'm looking at the polls along with you, team. So where you are in the career. And this is very critical for you to look at it. Can you all see the poll results on your screen? So 24% beginner, 28% QA trained, 16% automation trained. So if you add the working in QA, working in automation, that's about 32%. So the remaining 68% are in trained, but getting into the thing. So this is good, team, to have a kind of an information about who we are, where we are. And this training is absolutely built towards a lot of us. It's all about going in the right direction. There are a bunch of training programs that you can see. It just has to be complete where you feel confident at the end of it. I'm going to hide this poll. One more poll question. This is very critical for me personally. I'm creating another poll question while you're answering this, team. Sorry, I have to do this sometimes. I hope it doesn't annoy you all as an audience, but it's good to connect, good to know, because I can customize and do a little adjustment at my end too. Okay, I've got about 86% votes in, team. I'm going to quickly close this. Sorry, clicked the wrong button. I think you can change it, right? I think you should be able to change that, your option there. Oh, no, you're not able to. Can I know what you wanted to choose and what you chose? It does not allow us to change, is it? Okay. So Next time, please read the poll questions very carefully and then answer. I've got 93% votes, team, and I'll kind of present this. You chose one. I chose one, but it's three. So that changes. 11% will change a little bit, will become more. Too slow. I need to be patient. I is not me, it is you. 7% are saying too fast. I need to repeat videos. 81% right speed and managing it rightly. All right, team. Because the speed will increase. That is one thing that I will promise for sure. So do make sure that, you know, as we go through it, you are able to getting accustomed to it. There's a lot technical that will come through, but I'll don't worry at all. Not coding, nothing is going to scare us at all. All right. Last one, please. Sorry. This should not take more than 5 seconds from you. Okay. Are you participating in the current Selenium Live project? 3% votes in. 50%, 70%. All right, phenomenal. I've got 97% votes, team. And team, you know, so quickly getting so many of you participating shows your interest level. Keep that going. With the training or otherwise, it's a momentum. Once you get the momentum, it's great. Can you see the results? So perfectly balanced. I've never seen such a perfect outcome. It's 50% yes, 50% no. So half of you are participating in the live project. Great. So team, this is great. What you're doing in live project, just to let you know, we're going step by step, right? I still had the documents open. So we're going to do three projects. That's what we're doing. First project looks very manual. All you need to do is little element identification. The second, we're going to do a lot with Selenium WebDriver and Core Java. That is the topic of today's discussion, team. Oopsie, hide the poll. Yep, sorry. Now you can see this. Project one. In the Selenium Live project, very basic. And then project two, Selenium WebDriver and Core Java, that will be more technical for us. So you need to get into the depth. And then software development, engineering and test. And just to let you know, team, not everyone can participate in the live projects because of timing or other constraints. There are two things that you will get along with iTeLearn.com. As part of the JPACT membership, is also access to live projects that were done earlier. So if you go to Selenium, for example, with where we did the majority of live projects, and go on, click on the projects, the training project tabs, you click on the projects, you'll see the most recent ones. Where are the, oh, there you go. Here, there should be a bunch of project videos also. See how many projects we have. It is just fabulously interesting to watch them. Because in these, the major difference is I do not speak a lot. I am in the listening mode and more of giving feedbacks. Sometimes I feel very, very bad to give very strong feedback. But, you know, we don't know each other. It's all virtual. At least the it is very important from a learning perspective, team. Selenium Live project is going to be very little harsher. So please be prepared. Not harsher, just be prepared to learn, really learn. It should get into your system and rhythm. All right, all done, great. Last announcement before we get into the session, okay? I'm taking so much time each time, but not anymore. I'll just zoom this. I sent an email out, team, earlier. So please do note, because if you have not got this email, it's very important. I've mentioned about the new live trainings that we're planning this month between Manoj and myself and a few other trainers maybe. And today is the last day for the special sales. So please, if you have someone who's looking into it, then I cannot hold this anymore, team. Let's get this going. I don't want to keep focusing on sales and so on. I love training. That's where I want to be. Of course, my any product development as well. There are ongoing live projects. So, and these three things are very important, team. Live training registrations anytime, just go to iteLearn.com/webinars. You'll see the list of trainings and what is there for you to schedule. And any iTeLearn member, you're not restricted from joining any trainings. only certifications and projects which for JPACT members. Anytime we upload the first few demo videos onto our channel, it is repetitive, but it is most recent. So unlike other, you know, channels, we don't create just interview questions or this and that. It is the same session that you will see typically. Once you know the program, you're part of it. Membership videos, once you sign into iteln.com, anything that you see is content protected will kind of open up. Any questions on this before I can go on with the training, please? Because a lot of members, and just letting you all know, because this is important, today is going to be the last demo, last class as a demo. So from tomorrow onwards, I want to make sure that we have, you know, moving on with it. Okay, great. Let me see any questions. How to participate in live project? How to participate in live project? Once you become a JPACT member, you can. There are two sessions done on the live project. Both the sessions are in the YouTube channel. If we are JPACT, should we buy these separately or will we be able to see the videos later? If you're a JPACT, you don't have to worry for the two-year period time team. You have access to all the content that we keep making. That is a significant advantage for you. And I'm not selling any individual courses, team. It is always, you have access to everything. We're trying to downgrade the prices as much as we can to get members in, because it's a competitive market too. Web services training timings are 9:30, 10:30, but Selenium live trainings are at 10. Live project, yes. So I'm going to move the live project by 30 minutes. That's correct, Fiza. So there's a little overlap on that. I will change that. So JPACT members can attend these trainings. Of course, you can attend these trainings. Of course. And see, the reason I made this membership, can I tell you the most genuine reason, team? For a trainer, as a teacher, it is highly motivating when I see a lot of students there who are participating. You know, that is what makes us teach and do better. Otherwise, it gets very boring and we may not do a great job. All right. Let's get continued with what did we do in day four, team. So we kept on going with Selenium IDE. We did a lot of things, record and run. We wrote, write custom scripts without record and run. And there was a question that came up from one of the members earlier at the beginning that, there's an advice from a senior automation expert saying that do not mention Selenium IDE too much in your discussions, because it gives a wrong sign that you're more record and run dependent. And that is absolutely true. Selenium IDE, see, every tool, listen to every word that I say very carefully, team. Every tool has its own, you know, pros and cons. You are an expert only when you know what tool to use when and how to use it. You're getting my point? Okay. You have your set of tools, but your capability is to know which tools. So this was the training that we did recently, and this is a members training. You should see this training, team. Automation tools, how we compared Selenium IDE, Catalan Recorder, AnyAuth, UFT to a basic extent, Python robot framework. We didn't do Python plus Selenium WebDriver, but we did WebDriver plus Java basic code running like Selenium Web, and then robot framework. How does it work? And we compared it to lot of concepts. And this is not like an 1 hour session. We took 20 hours or 15, 16 hours to get to this stage, team. So every tool, Selenium IDE, we will use a lot for element identification and reconfirmation if our XPath is correct. That's about it. That's where we will end. Okay. Tim, give me one quick second. So, and then we'll get going. Any last questions, please? And I'm going to be on pause for 10, 20 seconds. All right, team, I'm back. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about that. Wait. Okay, great. Thank you, Chitra. You updated me on that. We also did Python plus Selenium WebDriver. And we did the sessions, but we forgot to update the sheet. I think we'll get someday and we'll add more into the sheet, more tools. Thank you so much. And yes, you also showed a demo on PyCharm, how we did it. Thank you. Great. Okay, all set. Now day five. So team, Selenium IDE, we saw commands in Selenium, what to do, where to do, targets in Selenium. We'll learn a lot about XPath in the next couple of sessions. You know how test data goes into the value column in Selenium IDE. Are you all able to relate? I'm switching the speed at which I'm teaching. So your mind should be on Selenium IDE, those four, three columns, command, target, value. And that's what we discussed. And then element identification, how we kind of get towards the basic sections of it. All right. We'll learn a lot about XPath as we go on. So now what is it that we're doing today? First is start working with Selenium WebDriver plus Java JUnit, okay? And then we will also do TestNG team. I'll write it so that we won't forget, so I can explain the differences between them. And when I said Java in the course curriculum, maybe I forgot to mention JUnit and TestNG, but that is definitely something we will go deep into. So how do we do that? The first thing and most important is you want to make sure that you have JDK, Java Development Kit. Okay. And where do you get this? Anyone? Who owns Java? Java is open source, but there's an organization which owns Java, right? So that's where sometimes we think, no, this is only answer, correct? There's only one answer. And easiest thing is Java download. If you do, you'll go to the website, oracle.com. All right. So Oracle is the one which is hosting or, you know, supporting Java. It's an open source tool, but it belongs to Oracle now. All right. I hope it'll always be for free. So, what am I doing? Java download is basically just to run your Java applications. We're saying JDK download. Java Development Kit. Okay. I was assuming team. I should kind of, I did mention it. See, I thought I didn't write. So Java Development Kit, oracle.com. Let me take this and put it here, the link for you. Okay. Members, I'll start giving you access to these documents. Weekly, I will zip it and send it to you. All right. But follow the videos very correctly. So here you have to make sure that you get the latest Java Development Kit 12. What is 12? I don't know. But where? Don't scroll down too much. Just stay on the top and click on this Java Development Kit. I'm going to do this again. Okay, so I clicked on it. Java Standard Edition Development Kit. Perfect. So you can write Java programs if you have it. Okay, there's general Java that is there on the system. There's Java runtime environment to run Java applications. And we have the Java Development Kit to build the applications. Okay, team. So here, scroll down and look at your application OS operating system. Windows 64-bit or 30. So it already recognized that mine is 64. If you have a 32, it'll show you those. Accept and click and say download. I'm actually going to get the latest one as well myself. So it's about 160 MB. Let me mention that also. So you know, 160 MB. And installation steps are easy. Don't you think so, team? It's just double click. Click, 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 kind of a thing, okay? So nothing is hard, team. Just imagine, think of it this way. Why would any company, even Facebook or Twitter or WhatsApp or Google, try and make an application non-user friendly, correct? They will always try and make it user friendly. So they want it to be easy. We sometimes read too much and get ourselves confused, but don't worry, it is pretty much very easy. So that's getting downloaded. The next you need to do is Eclipse IDE. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. Okay, now for sample, I'll just go and open up one of my any source codes. Okay, Okay. Just utilities. For example, there's a code here called low-level keywords. All right. Large code. It's got a lot of things in it. Now we've built this. This is part of the back end of what we do in AnyAuth. Now, how do we, what was I speaking about? I lost my thought. Huh. So when I look at this code, it is all text and it is all same color and so on. So the development as it went on in terms of so if you look at, okay, let's assume some timeline steam. Okay, 1995, all right? Around that time, plus minus 3-4 years, give me that credit. And now we're in 2019. I don't need the apostrophe, okay? When the earlier codes were being written, they're all text files. Then they said, we need some kind of an editors. Why? Because I have to build this. Okay, sorry, compile, build, and I have to then be able to execute or run them. And every time I'm using this view. And then came the concept that slowly, why don't we build something called as an integrated development environment, where you can see the code very nicely organized. You can be able to build, compile, configure, execute, run, all into. And so I think somewhere in very early 2000s, this started off being. There was Borland C++, C++, and all of those IDEs were there. But from a Java standpoint, I think Eclipse took off market in the early 2000s and so on. I don't know if it was later. And it said that I'm going to be the open source tool. Java is open source. What is open source? Open source is saying you can use my tool as you want. There's no restriction to it. And everyone kind of combines and joins as a community and develops components around it. Okay. So Java has become an open source tool, and Eclipse also is open source, saying that you don't have to pay to download a thing like Eclipse. So on a much more detailed basis, this is how you will see how codes will look in Eclipse and how we run, execute, and so on. But what we're going to do is we have to start with the basic. I will explain the difference between regular and what is the thing there. But eclipse.org, all right, team. That is the website you're going to visit. I'm taking too much time to explain this. And then Selenium HQ. Dot org. Okay, where are we? Okay, there we go. Eclipse Foundation. So as soon as you go to the homepage, just scroll down, team. Oh no, nothing here. There is a download. Download on top right side. This application keeps changing sometimes. And get Eclipse ID 2019-06, the different names that come for it, team. You don't have to keep searching. Just click on it. You would get your own choice bit there. They're all easy. So there's nothing that you would want to worry about here. So I'm going to click on download and let that download as well. So that's about 52 MB that's getting downloaded. Now, the problem is I don't give hard URLs there. If I give a hard URL to what we're doing here, it will change, correct? This will keep changing. So you go to the latest one and download it, please. The version that I am using is file help, maybe about Eclipse. And what I'll do is I'll upgrade to the latest one so we can all be on the same one. See, this is Neon 0.3. This was in 2017. March 14th or something like that. So this is a pretty old version and it's still fine. It works for me, but then I think I'll take the new one too. Okay, the next one is going to be seleniumhq.org, team. Here is where you need to download your Selenium web driver. Okay, so you have your Selenium server. This is the first one. So Actually, if you download this, it should be sufficient, I believe. Where is it? Okay. Out here. So you're going to download the latest one team that's already there in my machine. And if you scroll down, you'll also see the latest drivers for each browser. So let me explain this concept team. You'll all understand what will happen. Okay. This is extremely critical for you to get this strongly behind your mind. Now, what is automation? You take an application, okay, and say what all you want to do it. What can this be used for? It can be used to do a process, like someone has a task to do and they will do it. It can also be used for testing to make sure that the process is running correct. It can also be used for, you know, a lot of hacking and unethical behavior and spam and just kind of disturbing the whole experience. And that is why more of this I am a human kind of a thing keeps coming up for us. Remember? So wherever you go, you'll see I'm a human. Please verify that you're a human. So you cannot avoid the scammy things. And so what happens is automation tools are very powerful. What do? They don't actually control the application directly. They start with the browser in between. All right. So they connect to the browser. Over the browser, they know how that app works. But then there is not one browser. There are multiple types of browsers. Each company has a different way of presenting the application. You will see sometimes even today, if you open an application in Firefox or IE and Chrome, they may look different. Because the entire process sometimes is different of how they are developed. So there is Chrome, there is Firefox. You have to test, do it on multiple browsers as well. Not test, but all of these, correct? So automation testing lets you connect with the browser first. So each browser has its own versions, all right? From version 1 to version like 50 or whatever keeps going on. So this automation tool has to keep getting updated. Now, let me ask you all a quick question. I'll know how many people are attentive or not. What is this automation tool that we're talking about? We spoke about the application that we can do process. We can test it. We can also do hacking and, you know, disturb the flow of it in an unethical manner. And this any automation tool has to first choose the browser and then go to follow the application as to do what on the browser. What automation tool team? We're only talking Selenium here or any web-based automation tool. All right. So Selenium WebDriver keeps getting updated with latest versions to handle these browser version changes. You getting it, team? So Selenium WebDriver, it will drive the web through a browser. That browser could be Chrome, Firefox, IE. So for us to be able to effectively work on that, you need the right configuration of the latest ones of the drivers to do it. So you can click on, for example, Google Chrome driver. Let's keep this. And you would get the latest version for it. And latest table release is 76. I believe I already clicked on it, but let's do it again and download this. So what are the four things, team, that we've kind of did so far? Where am I here? So Chrome driver from SeleniumHQ.org. Why is it that I'm not mentioning about the Firefox driver or IE driver and all those other things? Let's first do it for one browser correctly, then we can worry about the others. Let's do simple things, then we'll do complicated things. Make sense? Now, once this is set up, Then we can start with Eclipse. Can I now create a small code in Eclipse and let's run it, team? Any questions so far? These are the basic steps. I want you to try them out. You have a question, bring it to me back in the live session and I will help you out. What is DLJDK and DLID? DLSC, standalone server D. What is the Selenium? I don't understand your questions, Rehman. Can once again, please? What is the difference between Selenium ID and Selenium WebDriver? Okay, that's a good question. So this is Selenium WebDriver, where I'm saying I have an automation tool where I'll write my code in Java, in Python, C Sharp, Ruby on Rails, or even PHP. No, what else was there? I don't remember. I don't think I explored more than these. And that tool will, that script is basically using Selenium WebDriver to be able to run those tests on the browser. Okay, Selenium WebDriver is nothing but a package. It will be totally hidden from our plain sight. So there's nothing that you could do to understand what is inside Selenium WebDriver. Bunch of libraries. Of course, you can expand and see actually what is there in that code. But your job is to use it as a blind thing. Oh, there is Selenium WebDriver. Then how do we communicate with it? We pass commands. Selenium. So once I show you Selenium WebDriver, you'll understand it. So you're all clear about Selenium IDE, right? PHP, Perl. I was right, right? PHP is there and Perl as well. Thank you, Chitra. That's helpful. Nazir can't hear me. I'm sorry. Okay, let's go now. So team, I'm going to open up. So here's what I'm going to do. Let me know. Why did I do that? Where did I put it? I always miss it sometimes. Okay, file, new, Java, no. I'll create, okay. Switch workspace, other. Where should I put it? C drive in trainings. Selenium September, I'll say. Okay. I think I'll take a little breath, team. Give me 1 second. I feel low on myself. I'm sweating as well. All right, sorry, I'm back. I'm going to change this and I'll browse to C drive. And here I'm going to choose trainings and then say, okay, it'll get me till there. I was basically just getting the trainings added here, making sure it's all correct. So team, so once we start working with Eclipse, that is our beginning point, all right? So creating our first project in Eclipse. All right, so we're gonna start working on this now, team. And I can't start documenting everything from now. It'll be a lot of documentation on the code itself directly, okay? But the first thing that we do, is to create a workspace, team. So what is a workspace? Think of it like this, all right? This is very interesting, the way Eclipse has been developed. Eclipse will be your friend. There are 1,000 things in Eclipse. You only need about 20, 30 things, all right? So your job is very simplified. Do not complicate it. Only follow whatever I'm saying, team, on instructions. What was I saying? What was I writing? I'm sorry. I just lost thought. Workspace. Okay. So Eclipse, think of Eclipse as a big, large window. I'm sorry, I cut the corners a little bit. And this is all my Eclipse. Okay. In my Eclipse, I will have something called as different workspaces. And I'll relate that to you. Okay, this workspace one. And in this workspace one, I can have multiple projects going on. Project one, project two, project three. And similarly, you can have multiple workspaces. So the whole point, the way it is done, is this is project 4, 5, all the way to 10, whatever. You can have n number of workspaces and n number of projects within each. The whole point is very simple, team. It is about, think of it like a desk. Earlier, before there was computers and so on, there used to be always desks and where people used to put files and so on. They used to stack them correctly, saying, okay, this table, let us put these project files, physical files with papers and folder, binders, all of them. And in this, we will put these on this table and we're working. And then it came to our own desktops, not desktops, our workstations where we work and in the office and so on. You have different cabinets. So you'll organize those cabinets based on what you want. So that real world experience is what Eclipse wanted to create in this world. So at any time, if I move my chair from one direction to the other, I'm doing different tasks. So maybe I have a coffee cup here on the right side. And my mouse is on towards the other side. My mouse also is on the right side. But I have water on the other side. So I can keep moving. Workspaces is that representation where one workspace you work on and you can create multiple projects in it. Tomorrow you want to do a new project, you create new workspace and create multiple projects into it. So these are all about how you organize yourself. Think of it like folders and subfolders. Fair enough? Now, to understand workspaces and so on, Java developers take a lot of time and so on. Typically, to become a good Java developer takes about 1.5-2 years, team, not 1 month training. 1.5-2 years, there's so much to explore in the Java library. We are not going to learn Java for that. Is that clear? Learn Java from a automation testing point of view. And I give a lot of emphasis to grammar, team. We are in the quality assurance space. We have to know correctly or use Grammarly. Okay, create a workspace, we spoke, and learn Java from an automation testing point of view. We are not trying to become a Java developer. Don't overkill it, team. There's a lot of other things for us to learn. Learn enough, that is essential for project execution and interviews. Learn enough to perform automation. What happened to my typing? Projects and interviews. Makes sense? And we're all in the same purpose, right? We are career development growth. Okay, done. All set. So that's workspaces, workspace two. Now, here's the most important thing. Once I say okay, it will start with my latest layout. It will close the Eclipse. So it's closing that and it will restart Eclipse in this new workspace where there's going to be nothing. So we'll start with a blank slate. Quick question. How many workspaces will you all have for the next 2 to 3 weeks? As you practice, How many will you have? 3, max 2. 1. 3 for each project, 1. Okay, stick with 1. All right? Just simplify your learning team. This is the fundamental mistake, you know, QA engineers do in getting into automation. Stay with 1. Just stay with 1. Okay, so this is your launch screen when you come to Eclipse. What will you do with all of this information that you see here? Where is my pen? It's not drawing here. I don't know. Okay, go back. See, it's like a browser almost. I have a back. I'll do an alt tab. It doesn't work. Go back. Okay, you just ignore this team. I don't know why my pen is not working at the right time. I don't know why. It's doing it somewhere. Okay, it's doing it here. All of this I want you to ignore. Don't worry about anything. There are 3 portions. Let me try again. No, I'll use my mouse. Can you all watch my mouse? The first and foremost is your menu bar. Okay, then we have this welcome screen and there's a little tab on the side. Don't worry about anything. The only thing you'll do is close it. Don't read or worry about that too much. When you open Eclipse, typically it'll start with this layout. What do I mean by a layout? It is a layout by mean that you have a choice to adjust the way things look, what you want to see, when you want to see. That is the power of Eclipse. There's very limited things that we will continue to see as we go along. Once you spend an year on Eclipse and working on Java or automation projects, you learn more. But let's get the most fundamental foundation level essentials. Okay. I don't want you to look at this connect my lens or close whatever you can. Outline, close it. Task list, close it. I only want to see 3 frames. My package explorer, this big white space where I'll see my code and any issues or when the things are executing, we'll see it here. All right. Now, the first thing I will do is file new Java project. And let's call this as SLT underscore September project 2. So let's think of that. You know, Selenium ID, what we did with what was that application? E-commerce was more of a trial thing. And let's get into another application. SLT Selenium Live Training. SLP Selenium Live Project, my abbreviation. Sorry, I should mention my mistake. So let's do more and more applications as much as we can, Tim. That'll test us a lot. So say, give it a project name, no spaces, no other things. You want to be very, very explicitly clear. Act like a programmer from here itself. Anything that you want to separate in terms of meaning, then please put it correctly like that. And nothing else to worry or look at. So I'll keep telling you what you should see and what you should not. I don't want your eyes to just wander around. You'll get confused. So all this area, leave it as it. Once you've installed Java runtime environment, it'll show up here. So use the latest one, default one, and click on finish. Don't even click on next. So it kind of creates a basic level structure team. Here is where you can start writing new Java programs. So how do we do it? The layout is very simple. It's like a tree structure. Think of it like a Windows Explorer, where we explore files like this, where we click on each and it keeps going to the next folder and so on. Same thing like a tree. The same structure now you will also see in the Windows Explorer. How? So right click here, you can go to properties and then under properties, see a lot of things to ignore, team. I don't want, ignore all of the JRE system library. Nothing of it is essentially important to you. It is just an assumption that it is doing its job. All right. And even here, as of now, the only thing we're doing is this screen and maybe later Java build path where we'll add libraries. So don't worry about anything. So in the first tab, resource, Java build path. nothing more than that. Even in resource, the only thing I'm doing is trying to get to the folder. See, this is the folder that will get created now. This is my workspace, Selenium September 2019. I have SLT September project 2 out here as a project. So that gets created here. Very important, team, for you all to keep an awareness of how we're building things. Okay. If you double click, you will see a few more folders than what you saw in Eclipse, but they're more of for you to ignore. The only thing you'll focus is this SRC folder. What is SRC? A short word for? Anyone? SRC means what? Source, correct. Source code or source code. All right. So your source code is all out here in that SRC folder. That's the same thing that we will see. So do I need to see at the JRE system library? Not at all. Minimize this. What do I have? A subfolder called SRC. See, my first folder name, my second folder name, part of under it, my third folder name under it. Clear, everyone? First, second, third. Now, in this, you could create your own programs. It could be a simple Java class. It could be a JUnit test. It could be anything that you want. What will we focus on? Let's create a simple Java class. Okay. This is like, I'll say hi team. This is the name I'm giving to the Java class. See, it took my mouse automatically on that field. So I didn't even kind of select anything. Leave everything. Don't even fill package for now. It just will complicate your learning. And the only thing I want you to do is click on this main method and say finish. Now, it's got something called as default package, but a bunch of basic code is already written here, team. This is where our Java programs will start to reside. So here in preferences, okay, what am I? I was doing it because I couldn't see it as well so clearly. So see, you have line numbers, you have different colors, you have it nicely there compared to this kind of a look. It is the basic difference we're getting. This is all black. This has got some colors and different colors. Maybe they mean different things for us. And it's also got line numbers for me. So that's a good improvement. Class name starts with uppercase, right? No, doesn't have to. I can start with, I don't know if it is, but it took it. Sometimes I get confused, team, on syntax because I work on Java, Python, VBScript, and sometimes C sharp as well. So, but 80% of the time on Java, just being comfortable with it for long. Method name starts with lowercase. Oh, are you saying as a methodology that method name start with lowercase and class name starts with uppercase? I've got couple of convention. Okay, then we will stay with the convention. So I've heard, I mean, at least right now from one of the members, and maybe I will stand corrected on that. The convention is hi team, the H should be uppercase for classes and lower cases for methods as a convention. Let's maintain it. Maybe it's right. There's nothing wrong in it. We will figure it out as we go. And I think it makes sense. As soon as I see it, I know it's a class name or a method name, even before I look into the code, correct? Very logical. Okay. What are classes? What are methods? What is Java? Forget everything. Don't do anything. Once you've come here, just do one thing, team. The first thing you'll do is system.out.println. See, as a type, you will also start seeing different recommendations coming here. So let's print like something like this, and I put a semicolon. Now, This is one of the simplest statements you'll see in Java team. Now, I don't have a good size of the thing. So what I'm going to do in your Eclipse IDE, right click on your what you see here, the numbers or this space if you don't see numbers. So if I uncheck show line numbers, it will disappear. If I right click again and show line numbers, it will appear. Keep line numbers always active. You need it. I will always refer your code by go to line number, go to line number when you share your screen. Next, what are we doing? Breakpoints, not yet interested. Bookmark task, forget it. So and so. Preferences. Why am I going to preferences? Only for run. One reason right now, I want to increase my font size. This is my editor team. It tells me basically everything about how things should look. Line number, how it should look. Print margin, everything is been pre-programmed into it. The colors and fonts tell me how my code should look, which font, which size, and so on. My only interest in changing the size, so I just click on edit, and I'll just make it a little larger and say apply. Okay, so now we have bigger code. So very simple team, what did we do? As a diagram, so you all registered that in your minds very clearly. We got Eclipse. Okay, we have Java, Giva, all these things also small, but Eclipse mainly. Then we opened a workspace. We created a project. I created a new class in Java, wrote a small statement called system.out.println. Now, did I talk about this statement? Then how will you learn that this statement will do what it does? You will, because I've said it now. You will keep getting introduced to new statements. What this does is whatever I give inside this double quotations, it will print into the console once we execute. Now I've written my code. I can see it is hi team.java. And I'm going to save this now and I will run it. See, I've arrived here so far. And maybe something like, I love. I haven't even got, I think I am only feeling I'm going slow, team. I love automation. See what's happening. All that Java program does is it starts from line. One line after the other. It tries to understand what, and team, I'm assuming that none of you know Java. That is going to be my approach. Okay. And that's what I'm teaching. So I'm not skipping anything. Is that fine? But the speed will keep increasing as we keep writing our code. Okay. Where are we? Okay. So, see this line one, it's empty. Line two, there's something here. Line three is empty, five empty, seven empty, nine empty. What does it mean? Simple team. The whole concept of programming is about there is a human and then there is a machine. Oops. I'm trying to draw a laptop which got off the shape. I can draw a space bar here. All right, so there's a computer and there's a human. What does computer understand, team? Do you all know even now? I mean, what does computer understand? What are the instructions that goes at the most ground level to a computer? How do instructions go to a computer? Oh, wow, nice. Thank you. Keep coming. Yes. All of you so far are right. If you've answered, you're right. I'm so happy. Keep going, team. Very critical. See, this is where I think our, you know, foundation gets laid. It's all zeros and ones, right? Every time when we work on computer, all they understand is zero and a one. So if I take a small cell block that can hold only one value, it can hold how many values, team? it can hold either 0 or 1, that becomes 2. And then when you have such 8 of them, so this is a bit, it's not a byte by the way, team. One cell becomes a bit where you can hold a 0 or a 1. When you hold 8 of these bits together, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that becomes a byte. So even if I have to tell my computer that I have arrived, there's so much of zeros and one in this. We cannot write in that. Computer only understands that. So from right from your operating system that is sitting on your computer to Java that is in between are being your translators. And this is like a human going to a new country and saying, I don't know how to speak your language. And why? Because you need translators. Java does that. OS and operating system will handle it after that. So all you need to know is how to speak Java language. Getting it, team? It is like learning Spanish or Sanskrit or something like that. It is all about syntax. And it is very strict language. It will not let you mess around things. So it's going to keep on disciplining us. Sorry, team. I just observed that I went beyond lot beyond the time. So what am I trying to say? For us, we need to understand the difference that this code that I saw, which is 13 lines, compared to this code where I see, which is only 6 or 7 lines, even I don't need this. Okay. And can I save as? And I'll say this is hi team 2. Okay. So now I have 2. Hi team is there and hi team 2. And a lot of things to learn, but I saw something, so I'll explain. When there's a communication gap between you and Java, Java tells you with a red mark that, or Eclipse gives you that. Java does not. Okay, Eclipse does. Your code here in a simple script will not look that way. Okay, Eclipse will tell you the fact that, you coded something wrong. Suddenly you see the reds here. It's saying my whole project is in a problem because there's some problem in source, because something in source is a problem where not with high team. The first high team, why I'm saying high team? High team is fine, but high team 2 is a problem. And most important thing is there is something called as a class in a main method. We'll come to it tomorrow, team. But the class name here and your Java name file name here must always match. That is your main class. They should be the same. See, as soon as I wrote 2, that red line disappeared here. But not yet here, not yet here, not yet here. Let us save it. Did you see that? So Eclipse will help you communicate back that Karthik, you wrote a code wrong. Correct this way, correct this way. And in fact, it'll do much more, but I want you to use lesser of Eclipse help, more of learning. All right, team, I'm good for today. Can we continue tomorrow? Last thing. So team, I may have to move this to a new webinar. I don't know if I'll have enough time to do it before tomorrow, but at least before the weekend I will do. So I'll see you all back tomorrow, same time. Any questions? Feel bad to kind of abruptly stop. Little beyond the time for us, but I'm okay. I have a few minutes if you anyone have questions. I'm done with the session as nothing we did much, but whatever we're doing, we're kind of going deep and covering. Tomorrow we'll do some JUnit code. We'll put Selenium WebDriver, we'll write it. Okay, no questions then, looks like. Great, thank you all. Thank you so much. We'll see you all back tomorrow. Any questions not answered? While you practice and so on, bring it up. And I'll also not mind to have you share your screen and share a problem if you face it to the training. The one question. Those of us that work in QA, how can I do live project? So Rehman, live project doesn't mean that you put 40 hours into a week. You could even put 5 to 10 hours into a week. It is participation. So that is what it is. And you don't have to necessarily be at the live time. As long as you're connected to the group in your own private Skype groups, WhatsApp groups, and so on. All right. And a lot of people repeat projects because your resume is not happy with one project. You need at least 3 to 4 projects into it. So and team, the historical projects, go through it as well. They could be good additions for you. Thanks everyone. Bye now. Bye all. See you tomorrow.